there's a combination of things that we would do to help somebody who has difficulty with taking metformin. When you first initiate the dosing of metformin, you would start at a lower dose. Of course, you know, sometimes people have very high blood sugars and you want to address that immediately, but you don't want to bombard somebody or blast them with a high dose of a medication like metformin, because more than likely they're going to have some type of gastric effect. There are some people who have no problem whatsoever, but we can't predict that in advance. So you start out with a low dose and you slowly increase the dose. The other thing that we would do or explain to the patient is that it's very important that they take the medication with food. Try not to take it on an empty stomach. Some of the challenges that I have experienced for people who take metformin are mostly of the GI aspect, meaning they have issue with stomach pain, some have nausea, some have bloating, some have diarrhea, some even have some vomiting with metformin. Commonly, the starting dose might be about 500 milligrams of metformin, and then we can increase the dose or titrate the dose up over time, like about a week at a time, to increase it to a higher dose. So you might go to 500 for a week, and then go to 1,000 for a week, and then depending on what's happening with the person's blood sugar, or depending on where their blood sugar started out, you might stop at 1,000 or you might increase it again to 1,500. And usually the maximal dose of metformin is 2,000 milligrams daily, which in many cases will be taken 2 times per day. The other thing that you have to consider is that there is not just one form of metformin. Okay, metformin has multiple forms, but the two major forms are either immediate release or extended release. So the extended release was designed so that it's encapsulated and that it slowly releases into the system, and people have found that they have less GI or gastric side effects with the extended release. With relation to taking metformin and trying to be successful with your patient taking the medication, rather than just focusing on prescribing a medication, focus on your patient first. Know your patient. What is the personality of that person? Is that somebody who's going to listen to what you have to say? Do you think? Okay, because obviously, you know your patient as best as you can. Build a trust with that patient. If you stop to listen to the concerns of that person, I think, is going to trust you and be more willing to be adherent to their medication. Okay, also, when you start a new medication with somebody, if your patient knows the side effects, knows what to expect when they're taking a medication and they have one of those side effects, it's like, okay, I was told that that would happen, and so therefore I understand that I should continue to take it until that time. But I may also open the door so that they know they can contact you. If you are concerned about the use of metformin, then you should learn more about it. You know, watching a blog or listening to one person's feeling about it is not necessarily going to do the job. Do your homework and see what your colleagues have said about it, what they say about it in the professional journals, because there's a lot of information, and there's so many research studies that have used metformin both here in the United States and in Europe.